Shalom, shalom. This is Israel United in Christ, and we are here to teach our people the truth according to the Bible. We are here to bring awareness unto you as concerning the times.
Right.
Understand who you are according to the Bible. For far too long we've been lost. We know not who we are. We know not about identity, who we are as a people. And all it is you find in the Holy Bible that was dedicated to you and only you, so-called black, Hispanic, and Native man. You are the Israelites of the Bible, so saith the Lord. You are God's chosen people, so says God. But we know not that for the lies that have been taught unto God's people. Give me that. Let's start with John 8:32.
Bring it out.
This is the book of John, chapter 8 and verse 32.
Now, Christ warned us about this. Read.
And ye shall know the truth.
Because today is the time where you must know the truth. Read on.
And the truth shall make you free.
Make you free from what? Make you free from all the lies you've been taught. Set you free literally once knowing the truth. What is the truth? Give me that. Let's start basic. What is the truth? Because this is the reason why we fell into the condition we're in. A lot of us don't even know that we're still in captivity today. We call ourselves free because you are free to do whatever you want here in this world. But what you don't know is that you were brought here on slave ships to serve a punishment that you committed, which you committed against God. God warned us about these times. Give me Psalms.
Psalms chapter 119, verse 142. Thy righteousness is an everlasting righteousness.
God's righteousness is everlasting. Read.
And thy law is the truth.
And the what?
And thy law is the truth.
And the law of God is the truth. We don't know that because we've been bamboozled. We have been taught lies in churches. They teach us the laws are not to be kept. Which is the reason why the crime rate here in Philadelphia is so high now. The Bible says thou shalt not kill.
Right.
Yet we do it willingly. Just recently a 13-year-old boy released 30-something shots on another kid.
Tonight, Philadelphia police say this 16-year-old is responsible for a months-long reign of gun violence which left 4 people dead, including a man who was a victim of mistaken identity. Investigators say Amin Hurst was the gunman who shot and killed a 20-year-old man on Christmas Eve. In March, they say he was responsible for killing 2 people in a quadruple shooting. And a week after that shooting, investigators say Hurst shot and killed Rodney Hargrove just after Hargrove was released from jail. Police say Hargrove was not the intended victim.
Why is this happening to us? Why are we allowing this to happen with our children?
I got it.
Okay? It's because we lack knowledge of the truth. That's the reason why these things are happening. The highest rated city known to man today is Philadelphia, brothers.
Right.
We lack the love that we're supposed to have towards one another because we know not God's truth. Read that part again.
Psalms chapter 119, verse 142. Thy righteousness is an everlasting righteousness.
God's righteousness will never fail. Read.
And thy law is the truth.
And God's laws are truth. God's laws are truth. So when pastors tell you that you're not supposed to keep the laws, it's because they know not God.
Right.
Understand, you do not know God when you do not teach others God's laws. Let's go to Exodus. Give me that. Thou shalt not kill. As a matter of fact, start from the top. Start from the top, because this is another thing. We are serving false gods when we act the way we act.
Bring it out.
Everybody claims to know God, but to know God, there has to be a certain kind of characteristic that you're supposed to be abiding by. All right? This is what God told us. Who is he speaking to? Let's get that first. Let's see who God is speaking to. Because a lot of people use the Bible, but they don't even understand that that Bible was written for a certain group of people.
Wake up!
And that's you so-called black, Hispanics, and Native men. The most powerful book in the world belongs to you.
Right.
But we don't know how to use it. Because we have been lied to by false teachers. False prophets.
Right.
not knowing or understanding how to use this book.
Teacher.
Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 1 and verse 1. These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel.
To the whole world.
Unto all Israel.
To all Chinese.
Unto all Israel.
Understand, this book was written to the Israelites.
That's right.
That's to so-called black, Hispanics, and native men today.
Right.
In the Bible, you would be considered a black man. But today you are, as a matter of fact, if Christ was walking here today, he'd be called a black man. He'd be called an African American according to the world. Okay? Christ is a black man.
That's right.
But many of us don't know that because of the lies that come from Catholicism,
right,
from Christianity,
right,
from our Baptists.
Right.
Religions created by man, not specifically white men, to trick you all.
Right.
That's what it was. That's what these religions were created for.
Right.
To trick you into believing into another God and act against God's word. Which is why we are so lost and confused right now.
Teacher!
The truth is that today is God's Sabbath day.
That's right.
But we don't know what that is because we're too busy focusing on Sunday.
Right.
Huh? Which is not the day of the Lord. Read on.
On this side Jordan, in the wilderness, in the plain, over against the Red Sea.
That's what God gave to us Israelites. He wrote it to us at that moment in time. Give me Exodus.
Exodus chapter 20 and verse 1. And God spake all these words, saying, I am the Lord thy God.
He's the Lord our God. God is the God of you so-called black, Hispanics, and natives.
That's right.
Out of all people, he chose you.
Right.
He loved you. He blessed you with the knowledge of this word.
That's right.
But you failed to accept it.
Right.
Read.
Which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt.
Many of you don't understand or even know that it was you so-called blacks that were in captivity by the Egyptians at that time.
Right.
We were the ones that he delivered during that time.
Right.
Okay? But we don't know that history because we are not being taught these things.
Right.
Okay? Read on.
Which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt.
Out of the land of Egypt. Out of slavery. Read on.
Out of the house of bondage.
Understand that? Out of the house of bondage. That's what, give me Deuteronomy 28:68. Watch this. Because here's one of the curses that God warned us about. Okay? We just now understood that Egypt means slavery.
Right.
Now look at what he tells us if we do not. Start at 15.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 15. But it shall come to pass.
It will come to pass. It will happen. God is telling you so-called black and Hispanics.
If thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
If we choose not to listen to what he tells us. Read.
To observe, to do all his commandments. Shall come upon thee.
You see that? Curses will happen to you, God said, if you do not listen to him. I don't know about you, but slavery is not a blessing. Okay? Living poor is not a blessing.
That's right.
Being called minority is not a blessing.
Right.
And that is what they consider us. Living in the ghettos is not a blessing.
Wake up, up.
Okay? There's nothing happy or joyful about it. People brag about them living in the ghetto like it's a good thing.
Right.
There's nothing good about living in the ghetto.
Wake up.
So curses will come upon us. Keep reading.
And overtake thee.
And they will overpower us. We can see it now. These curses are surrounding us. They are overpowering us.
Right.
Okay, read on.
Verse 16. Cursed shalt thou be in the city.
This is what we are, brothers and sisters. We are cursed in the city. Everywhere you go, no matter what city you go to, the people you find in the ghetto, in the slums, is so-called blacks and Hispanics. This is the Bible speaking truth.
Right.
Read.
And cursed shalt thou be in the field.
And in the field, you think about slavery times, which we're still, listen, right now, believe it or not, these houses, they were built on the same fields that we pick cotton on.
Wake up! Yeah.
These houses, these buildings were built on the same fields that we pick sugar from. Okay? Tobacco from. We are still in the fields. Today called a city. Read on.
And cursed shalt thou be in the field.
Read.
Cursed shall be thy basket.
Thy basket. What is thy basket? That's nowadays known as either your wallet or your bank account.
Work it out.
You understand? We out here begging for money. Why? Because our basket is cursed.
Hey.
We have no money. We can barely make it. We waiting for what's that? Stimulus checks and things of that nature. Which is only money that they take from you in the first place.
Right.
Cursed shall be thy basket, read.
And thy store.
And thy store. Look at all the stores that surround us. What black man you know owns a Walmart? What Hispanic man do you know owns a Home Depot?
Right.
A Lowe's. Cursed shall be our store. You know what we got? Mom and pops. That's all we got.
Wake them up.
We own a mom and pop. We own a corner stand. We selling socks that we have to go to the white man to get in the first place.
Wake up.
To try to make a dollar out of it. Okay? We selling hats. We selling t-shirts.
Right.
That's our store. The Bible said what?
Cursed shall be thy basket and thy store.
That's our store. Our store is cursed. Okay? When will we be able to own a Marriott? Huh? When will we be able to own a massive football field and call it ours? Huh? Curse is our stores. This Bible is talking about you, black and Hispanic man.
Right.
This is God talking to the people whom he loved.
Bring it out.
He told you, if you chose not to love me, I will curse you. Okay? Read on.
Curse shall be the fruit of thy body.
The fruit of our body. Look at our children. They're either locked up. They're either in a foster care. They're getting killed. They are killing. They are oppressing you as a father or mother.
Wake them up.
But there's a reason for that. We chose not to obey God's word. Okay? Curse is the fruit of our loins. We are killing the fruit of our loins.
Right.
The white man created, abortion clinics.
Bring it out.
And we run to them.
Right.
They call it Planned Parenthood. You know what that's saying? That's them planning your parenting.
Right.
That's them telling you what to do with your child.
Wake up.
Whether you should allow it to be born or kill it. Guess what? The Egyptians did that to the Israelites while the Israelites were being born in multiple. Get that real quick. Let's touch on that real quick. Look at this. Okay? History repeats itself.
Right.
The same people that killed us back then, those same spirits are trying to continue to kill us today.
Bring it out.
But today's a new day, brothers and sisters.
That's right.
The prophets are back.
That's right.
And we're going to bring you this knowledge. Read.
Exodus chapter 1 and verse
Listen
8.
Listen good.
Now there arose up a new king over Egypt, which knew not Joseph.
This king knew not about Joseph. He's the father of the so-called Puerto Ricans and so-called Cubans today. Okay? He didn't know Joseph when he arose. This is all considered what? The 17th dynasty. Okay? What was that king's name? What's
it
name? But anyway, go ahead. Read
Ramses.
It. Ramses. There you go. This is in Bible times. You Egyptians, so-called, if you call yourself an Egyptian, then you are the ones that did this to us.
Right.
But
unto his people. Behold, the people of the children of Israel are more and mightier than we.
Hey, that's the white man today saying these blacks and Hispanics are growing in enormous numbers. That's what they're doing today.
Right.
Read on.
Come on. Let us deal wisely with them, lest they multiply and come to pass.
So they got together and started thinking about a wise way to get rid of us. That's what America's doing today.
Right.
When there falleth out any war, they join also unto our enemies.
Because if we happen to get in communication as blacks, Hispanics, and natives, if we happen to join, let's say join China. Say the hell with America and join China. Say the hell with America and join Russia. We will overpower Babylon.
Yes.
Known as America today. Okay? That's what they're thinking. We have to do something to control these people. Because they will destroy us. Read.
And fight against us. And so get them up out of the land.
Watch this, read.
Therefore, they did set over them taskmasters.
That's what we have now. These so-called, these pastors' names? He's right, these T.D. Jakes, these Creflo Dollars. Anita Biden. These are our taskmasters today.
Right.
Your so-called famous football stars that come out and teach you to love America, those are our taskmasters.
Right.
That's what they chose to do.
Right.
Huh? Tyler Perry. Right? Your movie stars. That's who we all follow today.
Right.
That's why nowadays men walk around wearing dresses like it's okay.
Word.
That's called evil communication, corrupting the good manner of a man of God.
That's right.
These are our taskmasters. So that's what America's doing today. Read on.
Therefore, they did set over them taskmasters to afflict with their burdens.
To afflict with our burdens. Now we're out here struggling in these jobs. Some of us have black men as our bosses who are under a white man that owns the company. Those are our taskmasters. That's how they destroy us. They make us work on Saturdays. They don't even teach us about the feast days that the Most High has set up for us. Our new moon. Our feast of dedication. Our feast of tabernacles. The Passover. We have many, many feasts that we can enjoy ourselves as a family rather than wanting to follow these feasts of this world. Which bring nothing but murder to your people.
That's right.
And teach you about false gods and lies. So these taskmasters go to these churches and they celebrate these wicked holidays, but teach you nothing about the holidays God gave you.
Right.
Okay, we are lost and confused.
That's right.
Okay, you got more on that?
Yes, sir. And they built for Pharaoh treasure cities.
That was us. We built for Pharaoh treasure cities.
Wake up.
Okay. Darian Zion. What is it? What is on here?
Pithom and Ramses.
Understand. That was us building Egypt.
Right.
And today we have built America.
Wake up.
And we're still building America. We are America's prime source of income. The so-called blacks and Hispanics. If we took our money back, we will dominate America and make it ours.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.